Welcome back, guys. This is Wedding Advice by Pink Book. I'm Natalie.
I'm Melindy. And if we haven't convinced you that South Africa is the perfect place to get married, TV personality and event planner Colin Cowie explains why he chose Cape Town out of all places to have his wedding in 2020.
Enjoy the video, guys, and don't forget to subscribe. Leave your comments down below. Until next time,
happy planning.
It's very easy to design and make beautiful things and put the icing on the top. But before you put the icing on the cake, you have to bake the cake and you need all the right ingredients. And I've found that the South African, I don't like to call them vendors, because vendors park cars and sell hot dogs. I prefer to refer to them as my creative partners. So I have an extraordinary team of South African creative partners. It's been led by my friend Carly de Villiers from the South African School of Weddings. We collaborated on a wedding before and several other projects in South Africa, so I feel extremely comfortable. The past 2 days, I've looked at flowers, I've met with technical people, we figured out the sound, we figured out the lighting for this portion, and I'm headed to Cape Town to go and meet the next group of people, which I know will be equally comparable. So yes, I feel very confident that I can find the backbone that I need to present a very beautiful wedding. Being the planner that I am, for me the bar is always here. And I like to make sure that what we design, not only is it beautiful, but for me the most important thing is the guest experience, that things happen on time, on cue, that we take you on a fabulous journey, well thought out with a beginning, a middle and an end. So I have my South African team working very closely with my New York and my Los Angeles team, and I've got 10 people that have been working with me for well over a year on this. So from the fonts and the invitations to the flowers and the production and the layouts and all the things that are going to take into place to create the most extraordinary guest experience, it takes a team and a village, and fortunately I have one in New York, one in Los Angeles and one in South Africa, and between the three of them I hope I'll be the best guest at my own wedding. I would say that 60% of the work that I've done in the space of weddings in the last 20 years has been outside of the US. So destination work is something that we're very, very familiar with. When you're working with guests, they're traveling a long distance, tell them what you told them, tell them again, put it in writing, remind them, and then they'll be there on time. So it hasn't been difficult because we're used to doing this, and majority of our work is working in other countries around the world. So we're feeling very confident and very happy about our production right here at home. One of the beautiful things about coming and working in South Africa and embracing and supporting the South African industry is that the dollar goes a long way, and I'm able to produce a much grander and a more spectacular wedding here. And it's a great idea. All my friends have been to New York, but few of them have been to South Africa. And this is not the first time I've thrown a wedding in South Africa, so I'm very familiar with what's available. And what's not available, the world is very small today. You know, if I want a particular type of flower and it comes from somewhere else in the world, we're just going to fly it in. So working here doesn't necessarily prohibit me from having what I want. I mean, I did a creative presentation of flowers yesterday, and it's exactly what I want. Yes, some of them are being imported and coming from other places, but the fact that we're in Cape Town doesn't hinder me one bit so ever. I think the world gets smaller and smaller. You know, I've visited close to 100 countries around the world. I've traveled more than 14.5 million miles around the world. I've really seen a lot. And most destinations have a beautiful resort, fabulous architecture, wonderful interior design. They have a swimming pool, they have a beach, and they have a view. But no one has what South Africa has. And the idea to be able to take people on safari, and where your guests, no matter how fabulous they are the lowest rung on the totem pole, is a rather humbling experience. And then I think we have this very diverse cuisine. So I'm showcasing my guests the rainbow South African kitchen. So it's everything from the bush barbecue and braai to fabulous cuisine that we're seeing that's coming out of extraordinary chefs today that we have in South Africa. And then, of course, there's the amazing wines, and there's such a diversity of wonderful activities to do. Like Cape Town has just so many things for a guest to do. And it's interesting because when you think about it, the Chef's Warehouse was rated number one restaurant by the Pellegrino Awards on the African continent, not in South Africa, on the African continent. And the Wolfgat in Paternoster was rated by the Paris Restaurant Association as the best restaurant in the world. So I think Cape Town's kind of like the food capital of Southern Africa. And we're all foodies and we love to eat well, dine well, and have a great time.
Thank you so much for watching.
Hit the subscribe button, ring that bell, comment down below what you thought and what you would like to see next.
And until next time,
happy planning.